just fixed a couple bad files here. Markzware's InDesign file recovery service. And the customers generally ask, well, what caused the problem? Well, it's hard to say. There's multiple issues which could cause a file to go corrupt, an InDesign file to not work anymore, to crash. However, one of the common problems are corrupt fonts. This can be the form of an actual font itself, which is corrupt or damaged, the font file itself, or it could come down to just the font caches. Well, first of all, over here on Adobe's website, there's a great troubleshooting fonts on the Mac OS, and they're similar for Windows as well. And this goes through many of the common problems. Make sure the format's supported, make sure fonts are installed in the correct folders. Very important tips. And make sure both screen and printer fonts are installed. This is something which is a common pre-flight error, which Flight Check checks for and helps you find these missing fonts, by the way. Then we get into clear the font cache. And you can do this manually, the general font caches. There's also certain utilities to help do this for you. And further information for troubleshooting damaged fonts. And I'll put a link to this because this is important. If you get a bad file, yeah, we can fix it for you, but make sure it's not your system causing the problems, which is, not all the time the case, but certainly sometimes it is. So I'm going to show you a nice little utility I have here. And that utility is called Cocktail. Let me show you how that works.
All right, so here is Cocktail. Used to be freebie. I think you have to pay like $29 or euros or something along those lines, but it does a multitude of tasks. And for instance, just to start off with, under the disks section, a great one to run every once in a while is permissions, to repair disk permissions on your hard drive. Very important one. And there's a host of other things it can help you with. You can set up different scripts to, delete your spot-like index files, to rebuild your databases on your OS. But here is under the file section, you'll see a lot of different things that can be done. And under the caches, you can hit the options and you get a host of additional possibilities. Okay, so under options for your caches, you can see that you can clear up a host of different types of caches on your system, including CUPS files and kernel caches, virtual memory swap files, etc. But under user, what you'll notice is not only color sync caches, Java, QuickTime, etc., but also Adobe Systems Incorporated caches, or even from Microsoft or Quark for QuarkXPress users. So for InDesign users, you just make sure you click this and click for just that user or everybody. And just so you see, there's other possibilities as well to remove your cookies, your download lists. Very good things to clear out once in a while because they can cause major problems. You select OK, and then basically you come here and you click clear. And it's that easy. You don't need to go into terminal and type some commands if you're not familiar with that, or rummage around your hard drive and look for hidden files. This thing will just do it. You see it actually clearing the user caches here. This is very easy. Click of a button and Cocktail does all the work for you.
So that's how you use Cocktail to clear your font caches. If you're still getting bad files or have a bad file you need to fix anyway, Markzware can generally help with that. We have a basically no cure, no pay service. There is a $19 or 19 euro restarting the other machine where I just cleared my font caches. There is a $19, 19 euro one-time intake fee. That is not refundable, as you can see in the steps here, but the rest is quite clear, and once you pay the intake fee, you can upload to the submission form, give us as much details as possible, and we'll try to fix your file. Give it how to clear your font caches with Cocktail, and I'll also give the link to the Adobe site we showed earlier. David from Markzware, signing off.